Hey everybody, this is Cyrock Omega, and welcome back to Hearts of Iron 4. Last time we defeated the Axis, and also, who else was in the Axis? Hold on, gotta unmute, because we're doing multiplayer. Okay, we're live. So, last time we beat Japan,
yep,
and then we were just kind of getting ready for stuff, right?
Yep.
Alright, so now we're looking to attack the former Commonwealth, well, currently Commonwealth, but formerly British colonies that are in their alliance, and that would be easy one to take on.
Coalition of Free Commonwealth States.
Yeah. The Coalescing Commonwealth. So right now, the only major in it is their leader, Australia. So that won't be that hard to deal with. We just kind of got to pick a couple important spots. Right, and how many... What is supply looking like in my India? Maybe building infrastructure there would be a good idea. So, now let's get an army here, there, alright. I don't even have all my dudes on the European front. I probably just need, like...
Attention.
I'd like to have at least, I'd like to have my armies back up to being regulars before I really send them anywhere. I would also like New Caledonia to be like the best, or the best spot to invade Australia from. Auslan. Okay. We want a modified government at all. No, I probably should have went to... You know, anything other than civilian economy during any of those wars that I did.
Yeah, that would have been smart.
Yeah, that would have been smart. I'll just go up to partial mobilization now. All right. I'm just gonna unpause and then we can get stuff going.
Okay. I have two national spirits, but the first one's like four.
Hmm. Oh, what just happened? Oh.
You can do it, Kurdistan.
If only. What if? Could we invite Kurdistan? Oh, I really wish you could invite Kurdistan to the faction.
Why can't we?
Non-aligned.
Oh.
Like, otherwise they'd do it.
If we could... No, that would trigger a war with the Allies. If we were at war with Turkey, they'd do it.
Yeah.
But I am definitely not ready to fight Britain yet.
Oh.
And there that goes.
Hmm.
Well, so much for Kurdistan.
I'm gonna send them guns. I'm gonna send them all my old guns. Like 30,000. Or maybe I'll just go, like... guns. I can't even give them military access. Oh! That's how it works. It's time for World War III!
They were already fighting. I forgot about
that. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Well, that's another front for the Soviets. Come on, Kurdistan.
We believe in you.
We stand, Kurdistan. Yeah, the Soviets did not have any troops on that border.
Gardez vos rangs. Attention. Parez. Parez. Attention. Parez.
Oh.
Someday. Someday. Oh, somebody's already made a landing in Turkey.
Well, the Soviets did have that island, so.
Oh, yeah. All right, and the Soviets are on their southern border. They may be pushing in before long. Maybe it wasn't the best idea for Zambia and Zimbabwe to join the Commonwealth Coalition. Considering that they are completely surrounded by the Allies and the Legitimist Alliance on all sides. Like, sticking to the Allies? I mean, how could that hurt? Really? So I bought Pokemon Soul Silver off of eBay on the 9th, and it said that it was going to be there. It was take a, like between the 12th and the 16th, it should arrive. It is now the 21st. I messaged the dude because it didn't actually indicate that he had sent it. And so I messaged him, hey, I know stuff is crazy now, but I'm just wondering, did you actually mail a thing? And he was like, nah, too busy. Thanks, dude. You know, I mean, it's like, I had the thought, you know, if I can get a better deal on a different copy, I would, and if I could win it, I'd just like, hey, dude, took forever. I got a better deal. I want a refund. Come on, guy. Like, really, can you not just go to the post office? That hard? Or
drive by a mailbox?
Yeah, that too. Like, it could fit in an envelope, as long as you make it secure. Like, dude, seriously. I gave you money. Like, you don't, he doesn't know how urgently I want this. Like, when it says, when you give a date, and it's like, if he had said when I bought it or in the description, hey, I'm really busy, I might not be able to actually ship it for quite a while, that is acceptable. But when you say absolutely nothing for, like, days after the latest, your window of this will probably be here passes? Like, come on, guy. Yeah. Mm-hmm. All right, have a good night.
Gardez vos rangs. Écoutez. Attention. Attention. Gardez vos rangs. Parez. Attention. Attention.
I'm actually gonna step away for a second. I'll keep it on pause though.
Okay.
What other focuses do I even have to do at this point? Well, that's right, I could work on like all the naval and air force stuff. That sounds good. Air focus. Time has come to expand our air force. It's only 1943. Plans have already been made to start construction of new air bases to support a big increase in both personnel and aircraft. It's so random. It's so weird, the choices of where they want to put air bases. Like, I don't have an option. Like, the only way that I could change where these air bases would be if I like reload the game, and the places that they want to put the air bases are Mauritania, Iwo Jima, and Equatorial Africa. It's like Iwo Jima, sure. Equatorial Africa.
Yeah, that could work.
I mean, like, sure. When I want to bomb Belgian Congo,
which we will.
Yes, like once or twice, like a bomb or two. Like, you already have more dudes on that border than you need. Like in Nigeria.
They're not actually on the border, they're just walking to a different border.
Yeah. I have a dude that's probably just gonna march through Nigeria. He's right on the border with Lagos, so that'll be fine.
Make sure you have a dude to march into Gambia.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess I could do it with my dude, but he's not really worth much.
Yeah. I mean, he's there, though. It is a city on the coast and slightly along a river. Gambia is one of those countries that, like, really shows you that post-colonialism real funky. Have you heard of the proposition to make, like, the East African Federation? Something along those lines?
Yeah, you told me yeah. last week.
Yeah, we were talking about that. That would be so cool.
So, what would it be again? Like an Ethiopia-run thing?
No, not Ethiopia. It'd be Kenya, Uganda, Tanzania, and South Sudan.
Huh.
It'd be a real big country, like both geographically and population-wise. And if they could, like, we talked about this last week, but I think that could actually work. Yeah. I think that would be a very good thing for most African countries to do. And they'd have far more bargaining power. I mean, and they'd get plenty of money from the oil in South Sudan. Just being able to get to the coast for South Sudan would be a whole lot easier. They wouldn't have to deal as much with probably Ethiopia and, you know, other Sudan. World propaganda against the United States. Sure, why not? Not really easy. Well, grow rubber plants in Madagascar, that's probably a good idea. It's like, it'd be really cool if they actually made, like, if there was a decolonization. Like, the countries that you can release as that have quote-unquote cores here aren't real. Like, they're completely political entities that have no real relation to any sort of historical or cultural background for the areas. It's like, I don't know if there's a reason why Uganda and Kenya couldn't have just been the same country from the beginning. And of course, it's an incredibly complex and diverse area, so I could be completely wrong, and there could be one or two countries that actually have a reasonable, like, ethno-nationalist reason for being, but only one or two. Huh. That's weird. Like, a dude from college that I haven't spoken with in, like, kind of feels like a decade at this point, invited me to play Civ 5. Weird. Feels like a decade, probably more like. Man, 2014 was a long time ago. It's probably more like 2012, 2013.
Paris. Attention.
All right. Go ahead and this guy. These dudes can go to New Caledonia. Where are most of the Soviet troops? Making tons of fighters. Wow, yeah, I've got a lot of naval bombers. All right. Our airplanes will block out the sun.
Écoutez,
Oh, whoops. That's funny to see. Alright. How'd this happen? Wow. Alright. Well, look who's back. Did they go down the communist path? I don't think they did. Weird. A communist India isn't even very communist. Yeah, that's interesting.
Well, at least that's definitely gonna mean they're not a major.
Oh, yeah. Alright. Gonna pause.
We're probably not gonna get much of them, though, because of that.
Could be. Depends. I mean, India... Well, yeah, it's like they are... They're not gonna be major because they're... Yeah. I don't know. I mean, the ally... Well, certainly not in the first war. We always could just attack. We have a guy right there right now. We could always attack right now as soon as you want to go for a CB.
Do you want me to?
I mean, we're not going to be in any trouble, I don't think, if we declare sooner. They also might just not have any troops there.
Let's see.
But that certainly means we won't get much of this, at least. You'll get two states and I'll get one.
Okay, we got 125 days.
Sure.
Thank you.
What are you doing?
Oh, sorry, I was tapping my computer.
Yeah, I can hear that very well. You may want to switch to push to talk so you don't even have to think about that kind of stuff.
Let's see, how would I do that?
Alright, you just go to user settings. And then under app settings, voice and video. And then, kind of in the middle of it, there's input mode. You are currently on voice activity. You would want to go to push to talk. And then it should, there should be a button that you could set that you can, you hold it down and then you would be, then I'd hear you maybe put that to like, shift or control or something.
Okay, so you can hear me now.
Yes, I heard you.
Okay, so it does this work when I'm in game two, or do I have to go out to do this?
You should be able to do it whenever. Like, as long as Discord is open.
Okay. Okay, let me check. So you can hear me when I'm speaking now?
Yep, I can hear you.
Okay, awesome.
Yeah.
Attention.
So have you ever seen India win the Civil War?
I don't remember seeing any Indias. Yeah, I don't know. Like, I don't think I've ever seen India go away other than historical and actually succeed.
I've seen them trigger the Civil War a lot, and I've never seen them win it. The old state under Lord Velisco always wins.
Yeah.
Attention. Gardez vos rangs.
So do you have, like, Southeast Africa covered between Angola and Mozambique? Or do you want to have me have an army there?
I'm pretty sure I got this.
Okay. I'll just send these guys to Nigeria.
Attention. Attention. Bougez-vous. ordres. Paré. Aux ordres. Gardez vos rangs. Écoutez. Thank you.
I think I'm gonna change my mobile dudes to like motorized artillery. They're far less defensive, but best case scenario, you're not using trucks for defense.
I don't really use motorized. You'd be surprised how far frontline infantry can go.
Yeah. Yo, I should make some camelry.
How do you do that?
I just have them. I can just make camels because I'm France. And I have desert. Alright, so yeah, I'm going 6 motorized artillery and 1 regular motorized. I think that sounds cool. Yeah, it'll make it hit a good bit harder.
So, what do camels actually do?
I think they just, let me take a look. Brianna. Brianna, I don't even know Noah. I need to have dudes in Brianna as well. So let's take a look. How would I go about cavalry? Alright, so they have like a 20 width camel cavalry is 164 soft attack, 123.2 hard compared to horses. They're pretty similar, I think. Well, it's like cavalry do more damage, but I think, I mean, camels are just better.
What's
in
speed.
Hold on. They seem kind of similar. think cavalry might be a little bit faster, but I mean, it's probably just desert stuff. And I think they're cheap, too.
Cheap is always good.
Yeah. Naval rearmament. Our shipbuilding industry has been left to languish while we focused on keeping peace with developments in other fields. As a result, we are now very much in danger of being outclassed by our rivals in the Mediterranean, not capitalized, and the Atlantic. We must invest more to make up for the lost time. I'm thinking I may want to go down bomber focus so that I can just do better. Well, it's really all about just the speed of the research, and we're already so late in the game, that's not even that big of a difference. Let's do a military parade in Canada. I don't know. That'll teach them. No, Belize. Getting an airport there wouldn't be a bad idea either. New Caledonia. Girl of Dern here. Air base. And there go the Philippines.
Rendezvous.
Yeah, there's not going to be much of India to take.
At this point, I'm just hoping that we can take those two countries in South Africa.
Yeah. So which one are you fabricating on? India?
India.
Okay.
Hey John, could you make a save right here? I have an idea I want to test.
Mm-hmm. Hold on a second. Alright.
We'll be in the war in 45 days.
All right.
Australia is a major at war with another major. It dawned on me I can fabricate faster on them now.
Hmm. Alright, my dudes are off the western, like the south shore of like Java. You should have naval control. I've got an air base. Oh yeah. India. Commie India is very close to gone. No, Tahiti is not ready for a provisional government.
Will they ever be?
Once you find someone that lives there, maybe. Tahiti, that's Pacific, right? That's a little... Yeah, there you are.
No, not Jamaica.
Man. Also, Mexico has landed in Venezuela. The Comintern is doing surprisingly poorly.
Well, their entire strategy is to throw bodies at a wall until something sticks, so...
Yeah. The thing is, even where most of the places that they're fighting, they're not even really able to use bodies. That's probably why. The only place that... Soviets are fighting that actually borders them is Turkey, but they can't actually get in there. Oh, and also, Shibe Sanma is not even dead yet. Despite being completely surrounded.
You know, with Ma, it's actually viable to make an entirely cavalry army.
Huh. Interesting.
They have basically no resources or really anything going for them. Mm-hmm. So there's nothing from stopping you from just, instead of using infantry, use cavalry.
Hmm. Cool.
Since you can't even really make artillery because you have no factories and no tungsten.
Mm-hmm. Imagine being the warlord that got stuck with that part of China. Oh man, guys. Man, why do I gotta be the guy that's just in mountains and desert and whatever? I mean, they still have the chance to just become China. I've seen that happen a good number of times.
Yeah, it can happen.
Yeah.
And you're not really set that far back from having an entirely cavalry armory.
Yeah.
Because really, as China, your strategy is going to be throw bodies at the wall and, you know, you were just to build frontline infantry anyway.
Yeah. You know, I would like it if they give Poland buffs to cavalry. It's like there aren't very many things that actually make units more powerful in focuses. I hope they do it for Poland. Like, at very least, maybe, like, organization, if not attack and defense or whatever.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
And maybe if they make it far down the path, so it's like you have to have actually already have done well.
Okay, I've got the perfect one for Poland. So you know how a bunch of countries get a bonus to attack and defense on core?
Okay.
Poland should have a bonus to attack and defense on non-core territory.
Yeah, that'd be cool. Aggro Poland.
And you could probably like, only be able to take the focus after you've capitulated.
Yeah, that'd be funny.
I mean, it would work for Poland, because Poland was a major part of World War II, but all of the places they contributed militarily were outside of Poland.
Yeah.
Attention. Arrêt. Écoutez.
All right, my troops are almost in position to start preparing to attack Australia.
Attention.
I've got most of my dudes west of Nigeria as well. Man, Nigeria is a country that could do great things if they were to get a lot of their stuff together. I mean, just on sheer manpower, I feel. Like, if they were to, like, I'm talking real life. I feel like if they were to start making, if they were to, like, have a lot of producing factories, I think they could really build up an economy. But I don't know. Stuff's complex.
Our treasury manager's Nigerian.
Huh, cool. I would like to know exactly how Nigeria got such a large population.
I'd ask her, but I don't see her anymore. She's not on the same schedule as me.
Gotcha. Because it's like, it's just Nigeria. It's not like a region that Nigeria just happens to be made up of. I mean, it is specifically the country of Nigeria. Because I know they had a pretty solid economy in, like, the 70s into maybe, like, the early 80s. They had a, you know, a big oil boom. And then that kind of, I don't know if it was that or something kind of collapsed in their economy. Didn't do so well afterwards. What Nigeria needs to do is start conquering West Africa.
Don't give them ideas.
Attention.
Alright, what are we looking at time-wise? How long until the war?
16 days.
Cool. Alright, my invasion will be prepared in 39 days. No, wait, 31 days. How did the coalition of the Commonwealth get to war with the Allies again?
India.
Okay. That's right, it was the coalition, yeah. I keep
it's
thinking
all India.
Yeah, I keep thinking the coalition was because of is at war with the Soviets, but that's not true because they joined the Soviets, which is not true because I thought that because they are communists. So I got
So I think every ally nation that capitulates is one we might be able to steal.
No, that'd be great. It's such a weird glitch. Palestine is saying they, like, I apparently have resistance to occupation in Palestine, which is a country that I do not own.
The Soviets just canceled their non-aggression pact with me.
Oh boy. Where do you border the Soviets or any of their dudes?
I don't think I do. Wait, no, I border Japan.
That's right. Days, and I will be ready for an invasion of Australia. I can get Nigeria right now.
Well, 3 days and I declare the war.
Yeah, that's fine.
Attention.
Alright, I should... Attacked by the Maginot Line is kind of a double-edged sword. Planning speed decrease, but max planning increase. Alright, there we are. War were declared. I accept my invitation. Maldives. Malta. All right, I forgot about Malta.
Gardez vos rangs.
Leisure. Days. Come on, call in Nigeria. I mean, we'll capitulate them easily enough anyway, so. Belize, who is already dead. Dead Jamaica. There's India. What left is of it? Cyprus. Sri Lanka, New Zealand. Oh, getting the heavy hitters now. Don't freeze on me. Too many powerful nations joining this war. The game can't handle it. Come on now, game. Don't freeze on me. It seems to be frozen. Frozen? It is.
Give it a second.
Okay.
I've noticed this happens occasionally. It's trying to load something. It's not actually frozen, but it's not running.
Ah, Guyana. That was it. Oh, Nigeria.
That's who you wanted, right?
Mm-hmm. As I can tell, they only have one division.
Nice.
And we may just instantly capitulate the country. Days. We have good control of the seas.
Zambia and Zimbabwe are still not in there.
Ah, jeez. Bomber focus. Air support is an important part of both our defensive and offensive capabilities. If we focus our efforts on developing fast, more agile, and accurate bombers, we will maintain an edge in any land battle. Oh, what? Huh. Right, they somehow have that island. That's funny. Oh, there's Gambia. What was that?
I'll handle.
Yeah, you've got South Africa.
Gambia is in West. That was a bad.
Oh yeah, Gambia. That's right. Yeah, that little one. I was confusing it with Zambia.
Gardez vos rangs.
Imagine just chilling in the Azores and being like, you know what? I need to fight someone.
Attention.
Yep.
Attention. Aux ordres. Gardez vos rangs. Aux ordres.
5 days. Yep, there's Gambia. Easy peasy.
The greatest power in this fact.
Mm-hmm. It's a nice river. What can I say? Well, the Brits have made a landing in Crimea.
Oh, huh, interesting.
That's the soft underbelly. Days. One day. Now one day. Yep. Sorry, just grabbed Malta there. In just a couple hours, I think we will be heading off to Australia. And go.
Attention.
I don't think we're gonna get anything. We don't have enough occupation.
Yeah. We'll see.
Attention. Continuez d'avancer. Gardez vos rangs. Paré. Attention. Paré.
The Brits are not doing well in Crimea. I mean, they do have supply, but they had the whole peninsula, but not anymore. There's Zambia.
Too little to...
Oh yeah, what little Zambia there is. Oof.
Okay, that's one problem.
Yeah, that's something. Oh, I see you landed in Malaysia. Or, yeah.
Did that a while ago.
Alright, let's hope they have no dudes in Sydney. That'd be best case scenario.
Thank you.
Alright, and we have... landed, and they did not have any guys in Sydney. Nigeria is capitulated.
It's incredible that Alphonse the First can announce something since he's dead.
Yeah. Alright, I'm just really quick to do a couple things here. But should probably capitulate them. Hey, hopefully, at least.
Attention.
All right, and Nigeria's done. Excellent. I'm unpausing.
Maybe we don't want to capitulate them yet.
Okay.
You know, just try and get a little more a few more occupations.
All right.
Attention.
I mean, we're gonna have more wars. Participation than everyone would, but India, and India has like 49%. The next highest is the United States with 11. I already have 11.
Okay, then march forward, I guess.
Yeah, it's like, what else are we going to be getting at this point?
Paris.
And found some Australian troops.
Pareil. Bougez pas. Rendez vos rangs.
There's Zimbabwe. And, yeah. All right, we got Canberra.
Gardez vos rangs. Attention. Bougez-vous. Vos ordres. Vos ordres. Gardez vos rangs. Gardez vos rangs. Vos ordres. Paré. Attention.
Yeah, I think like the next city I take will be enough. Like it'll either be Brisbane or Melbourne.
Attention.
Either way, there's no one defending either of those places.
Attention.